Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you doing this fine day? Me? I'm frankly pooped because I have been spending a lot of time lately optimizing our website, the Dotto Tech website. I rebuilt this website this past winter. And when I rebuilt it, though, I made it very slow by adding too much stuff and not paying enough attention to speed. And speed, as far as the internet is concerned, is crucial. People do not stay on your website if it doesn't perform well. And our website was not performing well. Looked nice, but didn't perform well. So something a little bit different today on growing your YouTube channel, 100,000 subscribers, taking care of that home page, your website, how to speed up, or the things that I went through to speed up my site at Dotto Tech. Stick around if you're interested in learning a little bit more about WordPress and efficiency. This particular vlog that I do is all about growing your business online, growing your business on YouTube, and using YouTube to create an online business. And today we're kind of going a little bit, we're not going to talk about video, but we're just going to talk about the our relationship with our users and people who visit our website. Now, your website, you might not consider your website to be quite as essential as I consider my website. But increasingly, because of how we now use Facebook marketing and other with the Facebook landing pixel or for the Facebook tracking pixel, so that we can know who's visiting our website, so that we can later on remarket to them, that sort of stuff, we need our website to be performing well and to be an engaging experience for others. Now, bearing that in mind, I went through over this past winter, I completely rebuilt my whole website. And as is my tradition, I did it myself, learning as I went and making mistakes as I went. But finally, I was able to rebuild the website, which is what you see here. Now, I used a theme called Themify's Ultra Theme, which is from good theme company. Actually, the same people that make Shopify make Themify. And this is what's called a parallax site. If you take a look, there's an image in the background that other content flows up over top of. I quite like the look of it. And it's a dramatic improvement over what our old site was. Now, as I built this site out, I made a lot of mistakes because I'm learning as I go. I am not a WordPress expert. I am probably like you, where I know well enough to get myself in trouble, and then I dive in and try and figure out exactly what's going on. So when I built this site, I made a few mistakes, which I paid the price for over the past several months. And the biggest price that we've paid is this site was quite slow. It was taking in excess of, or around 10 seconds, maybe 11, 12 seconds on average, to load the page. And I did not necessarily know all of the nuances to speed the page up. And then I noticed a post that came out at a kind of a, I'm not sure if it's a brand new tool, but it's a recently promoted tool from Google, which was basically to get us thinking about how well our sites perform in mobile. And they invite you, and I'm just going to put in my site here, autotech.com. They invite you to test our site to see how it performs based on Google's parameters in the mobile environment. And along with that, they also tell you how it performs in the desktop environment. So when I first ran this test for my site, the results came up, and they come up fairly quickly. And look, they're giving me poor marks, but oh my gosh, those poor marks are so much better than my previous poor marks. Good news is that the site, the refresh site design, which is basically comes down to how Themify has designed the Ultra theme, is very, very mobile friendly. And it does resolve gorgeously, I think, in the mobile environment. The mobile speed is poor. The desktop speed is also poor. But these numbers are at least double what I was originally getting. I was getting in the low 20s on both mobile and desktop speed. And they don't seem to say very poor. They just say poor. So I'm still poor, but I'm twice as good poor as what I used to be. So what did I do and why did I do it? I'll just go through that. Now, this might be something that works for you. This might be an issue on your site. It might not. These are things you're going to have to decide. And if I am misspeaking or not explaining something 100% clearly for those of you who are WordPress experts, I apologize. But please correct us in the comments area if there's something that I'm misrepresenting or not explaining properly. But the bottom line is, as I went through this score, they talked about how important these things are for the site to load very quickly in mobile, how long people will stay on your site. Yeah, 9 out of 10 people are using multiple screens, they say, on a desktop environment, so your site has to load really fast. I'm not sure why the multiple screens makes that big a difference, but other reports that I've read say that if your site isn't loading in 5 seconds in desktop, you're going to lose people. They're just not going to have the patience. And they're saying here in 3 seconds in the mobile environment. So obviously speed is essential. So let's go take a look at kind of the back end of our site and see exactly what it was that was slow. slowing things down. And actually, I'll look at the front end of the site first and tell you where it began with. Now, when you look at the speed of your site, there's some factors that the average person isn't going to be able to deal easily with. There's the CSS. There's all of the kind of the framework and the architecture that delivers the site that you and I probably can't do too much about. What we can do something about is we can do something about how many requests there are on the homepage, how many redirects there are on the homepage, and how optimized the images are on the homepage, and also how many plugins we have, how many different resources have to load when people come to our site. That's something that we can think long and hard about and deal with. So let's begin with the lowest hanging fruit, which is the images, which ended up being my biggest problem because I thought there were tools built into WordPress that took care of the situation, but I didn't exactly know how it was all working. So we can start right here with the beauty of the parallax themed sites, these beautiful graphics that go in the background, which have to load, which if we don't optimize these images, make them as compact and compressed as possible, is going to slow down our site. So here's a beautiful black and white photo. I think it's a beautiful black and white photo that was in the background. And this was about 90 kilobytes in size. Not necessarily huge, but as I went through it, and I picked out each and every image and I recompressed it in Photoshop to make it as small as it could be with me still being happy with the overall, how the image looked. So I went through all of my different featured images here. First of all, the background images and then the foreground images and resized them. Now, there are tools within WordPress that resize images on the fly and automatically compress and optimize your images for you, which does help a lot. But having said that, you can still do yourself a favor by making sure that all of your images before you upload them are already sized to the appropriate size for the page that you're going to be showing them on and are compressed to the level that you're comfortable with, either as a PNG compression for graphic images and JPEG for photos. Now, where I made a big mistake was on these images here. These images are the featured images in my WordPress site. So those of you who are kind of neophytes to WordPress, when you create a post within WordPress, you can set featured images that are going to display basically how your theme determines each page gets laid out. And in this particular case, we've got a kind of a digest of all of our different posts that we've created. So it then looks in the website, it looks in the post, and it finds the featured image, and then it displays that as this kind of a thumbnail image in the display. Now, what I didn't know, it was explained to me afterwards, is WordPress doesn't do as good, or at least my version of WordPress here does not do a very good job of compressing these images. It compresses inline images that are part of your post, but it doesn't do as good a job of compressing these thumbnail images. So some of these thumbnail images that I had, because we weren't paying very close attention as we were uploading them, were up to 0.5 megabyte in size. My overall site, when I first loaded it, was 5.6 megabytes in size, just loading my homepage. By decreasing the size as much as I can, both the JPEG compression and the physical size of these images, I reduced the size of my homepage loading to about 2.5 megabytes in size, which was my single biggest increase in speed as far as the performance went. So that was huge for me. I went through and I resized each and every image, and then I had to go into the individual posts and I had to replace those images in the posts. So here's a case that I ended up having to do work again for work that I'd done before because, for lack of a better term, I did it sloppily the first time. I wasn't paying attention to what I should be paying attention to as far as the size of those images, and I paid the price. My site performed poorly, so now I had to go through and I had to clean it all out. So that was number one, and that's probably the easiest thing that we can all do on our website is go through and optimize all of those images. As a part of that, I also added a plugin. Now, you want to be careful about how many plugins. There's a kind of you're kind of damned if you do and damned if you don't with some of these plugins, because every time you add a plugin, that adds extra weight to your website. It's basically extra code you're installing that has to be loaded. But what I did add here is I added this EWWW image optimizer, which as we upload images goes through and compresses all those images as you upload them. And it's ideal for images within posts and basically your inline graphics that you're working with in on your website. One thing that it also does is it allows us to go back through our entire media library and compress all of our older images. So even if you've been bad up to now, you can improve things by installing a plugin like this and then going back and having it go through and recompress all of the images that are already uploaded to the site. Now, WordPress will typically do a pretty good job now of taking all of your images that you include in your posts and resizing them to the appropriate size for that post. So it'll create multiple thumbnails. And we have to recognize the difference between storing images in your WordPress database, which doesn't really slow down your site, and displaying them on the page, which is what does slow down your site. Now, I'm not going to recommend EWW Image Optimizer. It was one that was well respected in the online community, and I didn't test out multiple ones. I can't tell you which one is better of the different image optimizers that you can install in your WordPress site. You're going to have to decide that for yourselves. This is the one that I installed, and it's working quite well for me. Now, going on through, there's another plugin here which I've used a lot in the past and was really costing me as far as speed goes. And unfortunately, it's a tool that I really like, and it's called Optimize Press. Now, Optimize Press is both a theme and a plugin that does a great job of creating landing pages, and it'll also do membership areas and even create the infrastructure for online courses and that sort of stuff if you choose to go down that path. And when I first began in the online space, I used Optimize Press to develop my first courses. So I had Optimize Press all through my site, but mainly I used it to create sales pages and opt-in pages for things like my newsletter, for webinars, and also the sales pages that I sold my product with. Optimize Press did a great job of building those. Its competitors include services like Lead Pages and several others. And Optimize Press is very well priced, and it's quite easy to use, and I used it a lot. Now, unfortunately, it was probably also slowing down my site a fair bit. At least this is all what, you know, this is the information that I was getting from those that know a little bit more about this topic than I. So I determined that I was going to take all of the pages in Optimize Press and I was going to remove them. But I still needed the functionality of Optimize Press. I still needed to be able to quickly create landing pages and opt-in pages and sales pages. So I could have kind of learned to do that within Themify, which doesn't necessarily have all the hooks out that's required. By the hooks out, what I mean is, with Optimize Press, I was very easily able to create a page that says, please subscribe to this whatever, this webinar, and it linked back directly to Infusionsoft, to my CRM, and it automatically brought the person in, registered them, and it allowed me to basically enroll them into my email system so that I could reach out to them in the future. So there was a really nice integration for my business purposes to use Optimize Press. So what I determined we were going to do is we created a subdomain. We created another site that's part of the Dotto Tech domain, but it's not the main Dotto Tech site. It's now members.dottotech.com, and that's where I'm going to host all of my landing pages. So I then had to go through the entire site. I had to find each and every page that required Optimize Press in order to display properly, and I had to basically pry those out and recreate those, export those into the membership page. This took me 2 days. It took me 2 days of just going through and finding pages, rebuilding them, putting them across, and trying to find all of the backlinks so that I could direct all of the traffic to them so that we didn't have broken links. And when you embark on a journey like this, to be honest, you're going to break a few dishes. I've been getting a steady stream of emails for the last several days of people saying, Steve, I was trying to go and watch this webinar replay or trying to opt in for this free download, and it's broken. What's happening? So I had to go through, and I've been fixing those for several days. I think we've got most of them fixed, but there's still probably the odd one that's still going to pop up. Now, so in order to kind of mitigate the damage, what I did was I've I've left Optimize Press installed, but not active, so I can activate it quickly if I need to go in and find a page that we've lost. But then I've taken all of the pages that are related and I moved them into the trash. I haven't actually deleted them from the trash, so I can still gain access to them if I need them to see exactly what pages are broken. And I'll probably leave this up for about them in the trash for about another 10 days to 2 weeks until pretty much I'm sure that all of the pages, at least the pages that people visit on a fairly regular basis, are now firing correctly. This was a huge project. I basically was consumed by doing this and having to concentrate and focus so much energy on this that I had no time to do other videos. You might have noticed that we've produced a few less videos in the past couple of weeks because this project was that big. It was probably, I wouldn't say it was as much work as doing the website originally, but there was a lot of learning, a lot of research as I went through cleaning it up. And it was just a very frustrating process because I was redoing work that I've done before that if I'd known better to begin with, I wouldn't have had to do. Now, if I had hired somebody to do my website, would they have counseled me against this? Possibly. I could have avoided this if I'd brought in professional help as we went along. But the bottom line is now I understand exactly what happens on the website. And maybe if you pay attention, you can you can learn from my lesson so this won't all be for a loss. Once I moved everything out of Optimize Press and got it all migrated across and had all of my images compressed, then what I did is I went through and I took a look at all of the different extra plugins that we have installed, and I really had a heartfelt conversation with myself about whether or not these are tools that I'm going to continue to use. Things like my pop-up manager that pops up opt-ins for the website. Very efficient as far as creating new people registered to our database so that we and sign up for our mail list, but also resources being used and the website slowing down as a result of that. So you have to go through, and I'm basically making decisions on all of these additional features that I've incorporated in the website and determining whether or not we're going to keep them. The other big thing that we added is we added something called W3 Total Cache, which is something which caches your website, and I don't understand all the specifics, but what it does is it preloads a lot of your elements so that they fire off more quickly. Now, there's a variety of different ways that you can use caching services or caching technology to make your website work faster, including offloading a lot of your heavy resources to other servers that as soon as people come to your site, everybody kind of swarms over top of the person that's receiving, and then they fire off information from multiple sources all very quickly so that websites launch very, very quickly. It's a little bit too sophisticated for me. Don't know if it's something that is going to would make that big a difference. So it's something that I haven't yet engaged in, but I'm still learning about it. Certainly those of you that are up to speed on what's happening with WordPress will understand what I'm talking about a little bit more. Those of you who have very resource-intensive websites, you should do more research into that space as well. Bottom line is I'm pretty pleased with the way it all turned out. As far as I'm concerned, the website looks as good as it ever did. The lower resolution images or the smaller images seem to look just as good in all the environments that I'm looking at them in, but the site is loading at least twice as fast. It's down to about 5 seconds in loading time, which I think is well within the range of being acceptable. Certainly, I'm not going to spend another week trying to go to the next level of optimization, but really, I wish I had done this first, kind of deep dive into optimization when I first set up the site. But you're concerned with so many things as far as design elements and functionality and flow and just, your overall business process and the website, that dealing with the actual technical clarity of your website, how well it loads and how fast it loads, it's understandable that it kind of slides into second place as far as your importance goes. But if you can, it would be certainly worthwhile making the extra energy as you launch it and as you build it. Having said that, now we're up and running again, and I'm back to thinking about making videos again, and with the full confidence that my website is working better than ever, and still occasionally now having to apologize to people for them not finding resources they want, figure out exactly what page was broken, and fix that page. But that's now getting to be quite easy, and actually, to be honest, there are very few emails coming my way now of broken resources, but I'm sure there will be a few more. Now, there are three ways for you to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel, and secondly, subscribe subscribe to our newsletter. Then you'll hear about all upcoming tutorials, webinars, and free trainings that we offer here on Dotto Tech. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel supported by the generosity of you folks at the crowdfunding site Patreon. I encourage you to drop by our Patreon page, take a look, and see exactly what's involved in supporting Dotto Tech and what perks come your way should you choose to become one of our patrons. Until next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.